activist Sudha Bhardwaj has been released from jail. Remember, she's been in jail since August 2018. And finally, after the trial court finalized her bail conditions yesterday, she has now been released from Baikula jail, where she has spent the last 3 years of their strict bail conditions in place. Remember, she had been granted bail by the Bombay High Court on technical grounds, and that had been upheld by the Supreme Court. The NIA had actually gone to the Supreme Court against the bail that was granted to Sudha Bhardwaj, but the Supreme Court rejected it. They found no reason to interfere in the matter. There you saw Sudha Bhardwaj waving to the media. She's not allowed to speak to the media. That's one of the conditions of her bail. She was arrested in the Bhima Koregaon case, which is related to the violence that took place in Bhima Koregaon near Pune. There has been widespread criticism and condemnation of her incarceration. For 3 years, she's somebody who has dedicated her life to tribal rights, to working with the underprivileged and the poor. She is a lawyer, someone who gave up an American citizenship so she could serve the poor in the country. So many had questioned the arrest, especially given that the charges, the evidence has just not been brought as expected. It's been 3 years since she's been arrested. As the NIA continues to investigate this case, they have not presented that charge sheet. So Sudha Bhardwaj finally released from jail after 3 years. Let's go across to Saurabh Gupta now for more. And Saurabh, we saw Sudha Bhardwaj, coming out of the building and getting into the car. She waved to the media. She's not allowed to speak to the media. One of the very strict conditions of her bail, isn't it?
Yes, absolutely. You know, her family, friends say they are very happy that she's finally been released. But of course, what also needs to be considered is that several other activists continue to languish in prison on terror charges, who've been booked under the UAPA, the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act, in the Elgar Parishad case, which was registered in the aftermath of the violence at Bhima Koregaon near Pune in January 2018. And she's been accused of instigating violence against the state. So this is, of course, something that is very, very serious charge, and many have questioned the evidence, and many have said that this is perhaps the high-handedness of the state coming down on activists also. But the other thing that also has been questioned is the nature of the evidence. Now, much of it is electronic evidence is what we've been given to understand, and the Arsenal Group's report, if you consider, which is of course an international forensic analysis group, they have said that it seems that the computers of at least one of the co-accused, if not others, was compromised, and the evidence may have very well been planted. Now, this is, of course, something that's a very, very serious charge in terms of the evidence that has been used to put Sudha Bhardwaj and other activists behind bars. Many have questioned that just because they've taken a stance against the state, that she and other activists have faced this, including Father Stan Swamy, an octogenarian Jesuit priest who died in custody after developing health-related issues in prison, and which only got worse. And then, of course, he was moved to hospital, but he was still in custody and he died in custody. That is, of course, one thing. The NIA tried to keep Sudha Bhardwaj also in jail. They moved the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court said that they had no reason to interfere with the Bombay High Court order granting a default bail. Now, why default bail? Because the Bombay High Court found that the judge who had extended her custody and taken cognizance of the case was not equipped or competent to do so because he had not been notified as a special NIA judge under the NIA Act. This is not a comment on the case, but the Bombay High Court nevertheless granted her this default bail. The NIA moved the Supreme Court challenging the order. The Supreme Court found no reason to interfere with the Bombay High Court's orders. And then, of course, yesterday, the terms and conditions for her bail were fixed. Very strict conditions. She cannot speak to the media. She cannot leave Mumbai. She's to attend all days of trial. And today, finally, after that process was complete, yesterday that process couldn't be complete, but finally that process was completed, and Sudha Bhardwaj walked out of the Baikula jail gates from here just a short while ago. This is, of course, the latest that she's left the prison. Where she's staying, how, what she's going to do next. She can't leave Mumbai, so all of those things have to be worked out. She's, of course, from Chhattisgarh, so she wanted to go back to Chhattisgarh and practice law. That's something that has not been allowed. But, of course, Sudha Bhardwaj is finally out of prison. Other activists are still in jail in a case that has been questioned. The very basis of that case has also been questioned. So that's something that is the latest, Sudha Bhardwaj has of course been released from the Baikala Women's Jail just a short while ago this afternoon.